Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, hi, my name is Maria, and today I'm with Ethan, and we're gonna be talking about tattoos. So a couple days ago, we got tattoos together, and ever since then, we decided to make a video all about it and answering a couple of questions that people might have. Even though there's a million videos about tattoos that you can watch, we decided to have our own, especially for the people that know us personally. So I've accumulated some questions in my notes, and I also asked on my Instagram, which by the way, you should follow me there. I asked my followers to ask me questions about the tattoos, and we're gonna be answering those as well. So let's get started. So my tattoo is a triangle with a hibiscus flower in it, and it's on my upper forearm. Oh, so he has two tattoos. We're gonna be talking about both of them. We were planning on having just to talk about the new ones, but then might as well include all of it.
It's got like a little banner, and it says in it per ardua ad astra, which is Latin for through adversity to the stars. And then number two, it's just basically a geometric shape. There's some lines, some circles.
So for me, the triangle, in my opinion, is first of all my favorite like geometric shape, and then also for me it means like womanhood in a sense. I don't know how, but it just means womanhood. And then the flower is a hibiscus dedicated to my mom, because we have an inside joke about the very berry hibiscus refresher from Starbucks. It means like, it's so basic, but for me it just like means a lot, and it's just so funny to me. Like, you know, if it's an inside joke, it's an inside joke. Nobody else can understand it except for you or somebody else. But also it's just like a flower for femininity. Basically it's just like womanhood in general. I just love womanhood and women, you know, I just support that. So that's my meaning.
So the first one I got, the Latin phrase was something that when I first got it, my parents wanted it to have meaning. So I spent about a couple of days trying to find something that had meaning for me, because it means through adversity to the stars. I thought that was something that would be good to get on me, that would stay with me forever, could almost sort of like guide me through tough times. And then the second one, the design in and of itself doesn't have any meaning, but I sort of assigned meaning to it. I assigned independence to it because it was the first tattoo I ever paid for myself, and that was a good feeling.
First of all, I've been wanting one ever since I was a kid. Like, my parents always looked down upon it, but like when your parents like constrict you from something, you kind of want it more, you know what I mean? So that's basically what happened. Plus I like got more educated on tattoos. Like, they don't necessarily have to be like for prisoners. They don't have necessarily to have like bad meaning. They can have good meaning and like good intentions. So I was like, you know what, like I like art. I want to decorate my body in some kind of way, and I thought like tattoo would be great.
I was just wanted one. Well, actually for a while I didn't, and then like I had a great time. Like, yeah, I could do a tattoo. I found the phrase I wanted, and then I just sort of looked at Google Images, and I saw one that was like, it was similar, it was like the same idea of a banner and it had a sword through it, so I just sort of changed that.
I always had an idea to get like a tattoo of a triangle on my inner arm or fingers or anywhere, but I always wanted a triangle tattoo. I don't know why, but I just always loved triangles for some reason. I'm really weird, but anyway. So I always had like an idea in mind, and then I'm like, well, how am I supposed to get a tattoo without getting my parents mad? So I'm like, I'm gonna incorporate my mother in some kind of way. He gave us like 5 minutes to email him our design. Then he took 15 minutes to actually make a stencil of our design, like a basic stencil, so he could like fill it in and like improvise or whatever, like, yeah. He did to your tattoo. Goes to a station, shaves whatever part of the body you wanna get a tattoo on, sterilized the place, moisturized it, puts a stencil on, and then he puts the needle in, and then gets the ink, and then just like goes for it, you know, like stretches out your area or whatever. Make sure it's flat and just go for it. And then after he was done, he wiped all the ink off of our skin.
Took some pictures.
Bandage, yeah, so he like put something on it and then wrapped it around. The place that we went to is Future Skin Tattoos, downtown Ottawa. If you want more information, I'll link them down below. Seemed like it was a new place, so they probably like got a new area to work in, so it looked kind of new. Really spacious, really clean.
Pretty chill.
Very chill. Like,
it looked very modern.
Yeah, and the people were like really nice too. Like, they were so chill. They're like, oh, you're getting tattooed? What do you want? So
I don't find it very painful, actually. 10 minutes in, I'm like, ah, this is fine. And then I just sort of like zone out. The only times it hurts is when the guy's going over and doing a spot that's already been done because it's already raw, or when it's like shading.
For me, on the other hand, the pain was excruciating. It all depends on the person, but most people say that it's like a cat scratching you. For me, it felt like a knife. And then I asked like, so how deep is it going in? Because it feels like a knife. And he was like, 3 layers of skin out of 7, right? Or 6, 7. And I was like, that's, it feels like 5 and 7. You know what I mean? Like, it's so painful. But the most painful part for me was when he was drawing like the outline, like the flower and the triangle, like just the lines, because he would go over it and like make long lines. Like the short ones were like fine because I would like breathe in, breathe out like really nicely, but like the long ones I would just like hold it in for a long time and shake, and I'm like, oh my god, this actually hurts. The shading, like, yeah, it was like painful, but it was tolerable because it was kind of fast and not a lot of shading was there, so it was, yeah, like it was fine. Also, speaking of the pain, the place that we went to, they gave me a stress ball to hold. And you know, normally stress balls are like for your hands to play with and like squeeze. Me, on the other hand, I put it in between my knees because my legs were shaking, right? You remember them shaking vigorously? Yeah, so my legs were shaking, so I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna put it in between my knees and just like squeeze as tight as I can, just to like get the nerves towards my legs, so like my brain thinks about my legs more than my arm. So, are you happy with the result?
You're damn right I am.
Me too. It's so nice. I like yours a lot.
Thank you. I like yours. It's very good.
I think you just said that because I complimented you.
No, that's not true. It's nice.
Oh, it's very nice. So we both paid $200 without tax. The biggest reason why we didn't pay tax is because we were called in at like 1:30, but we got our tattoos started at like 4 or 5.
3. I think mine was like 3:30.
Yeah, so we had to wait a little while. So yeah, well, I mean, tattoos are pretty expensive, but like if you get them done at a really professional place with professional artists, it kind of makes sense if you want the best result. Instead of going to like a sketchy place, paying $50 for a tattoo that will like scab away in like a couple of days and just like get washed off.
Or like get infected or something.
Yeah.
It also depends on like size and what color ink you're using.
And if there's shading or not.
Yeah.
And if there's color, yeah, like you mentioned.
You have to be 100% certain you want this done, because once you start, there's no going back.
Yeah, really think about it. And also, I would say like plan ahead, do your research, like how do tattoos work? How do they do that? What's the process? So you're kind of educated and you come into the area and you're like, oh, I know what's going on. I know what he's doing to my arm or what he's doing to my legs or something. Like, you know, why is he shaving? Well, if you do your research, you would know why.
There's also no physical way to prepare for the pain. It's just, yeah, mentally, this is gonna hurt, and it's gonna hurt for like an hour.
Another tip would be like to eat. Eat a lot so that you have enough blood circulating through your veins, because you're gonna lose a couple of blood drops when you get a tattoo. But also, because you're like tolerating the pain, a lot of blood will go to that area. So make sure that you're fed well and have enough energy to get it, but also for mental energy.
Surprisingly draining.
It is so draining.
And it's not like you're doing anything. You're just laying there for like an hour, but when you get up, you're so tired.
But also depends on what kind of tattoo you're getting, because it can be an hour, it can be an hour and a half, 2 hours, whatever.
Like 2 minutes.
That's another advice. Like, be prepared for the amount of time you're gonna, yeah, be sitting or laying down, whatever you're doing. So even if you have a good sleep, like, be prepared to be very tired after because of what your body's going through. I know, like, the adrenaline, I'd say.
I didn't feel much adrenaline, but...
Oh, I felt so
I was
adrenaline.
Just like...
I was
ready to go to sleep.
I was so tired.
My arm or my hand was, like, cramped from holding it out.
Yeah, yeah,
in,
yeah,
a certain position.
Yeah. I also forgot to mention that after you get your tattoo done, make sure you moisturize and clean it. And...
Don't pick at it.
Don't pick at it. Mine's currently peeling, actually. I'm gonna show you a clip. But don't pick on it. Do not touch it. Just moisturize it and wash it a lot. So make sure you do that. Anyway, go back to the normal video.
Yeah, probably.
Me too. Like, I'm not thinking of doing it like right away, but like in a couple of years, if I think of something, then yeah. It is true. Once you get your first tattoo, you kind of want more. Smaller ones.
Yeah, smaller. Probably in the same idea as the geometric one. Unless I find something that has meaning and I can put that in a symbol or something.
I would do more meaningful ones because I feel like it has more purpose to be on your body. So now that we're done with the basic questions that I came up with, we're gonna go into the questions that people asked me on Instagram. The first, how long did it take you to decide on the tattoo? For me, it was a month.
The day I searched up geometric tattoos and I saw that one, I'm like, yeah, this is what I want. But then the process between figuring out that's what I want and actually getting it done was probably like a month and a half, would you say?
Mm-hmm. Did you guys have any other tattoos designs in mind? I don't know if she means like in future or like before. Like when you looked up a geometric shape, was this the first one that you came up with, or was there other ones that
there were other ones that I'm like, oh, this is cool, but this is the one that actually stood out to me.
Mm-hmm.
But then like the day of, I had that other idea for making it sort of smaller. That's not really one I was planning on getting.
My other designs were like just bouquet of flowers or like a couple of branches of flowers and like
a lot of flowers,
like just like floral designs. How much is a smaller tattoo typically? Also, how much does a smaller tattoo hurt? We don't know.
I guess it depends on the size.
Really depends on how small you're talking about. Like, if it's like smaller than ours, then yeah, it might be cheaper.
If you're getting like a tiny moon on like the back of your ear or on the wrist or something. $7,500 maybe.
I would recommend on going to a tattoo place and actually ask them face to face, like, how much would you think this would be? And they would like give you an average range of how much they would
because
charge you for
it. The place we went to, then we got a different quote than what we actually paid. But like, there are people coming in, here's the design, here's where I want it, how much would that cost? And then the guy would give them an idea.
How much would it hurt? Probably less, because the bigger the design, the more ink comes in and the more needle work has to be done. So obviously it's gonna hurt less.
Yeah, even if it's just like an outline of a moon, that's just like
5 minutes
maybe.
That's maybe like 3 lines maximum. Actually, no, it's just 2 lines because they don't stop. How can you stand the pain of stabbing?
Falling asleep.
Having a stress ball. Or music. Oh, I listen to a lot of music. I just plugged in my headphones and I'm like, I'm distracted. I'm gonna sing along to my music. I like a swimming pool of stone, where the water